Just give me a reason to keep my heart beating. Don't worry, it's safe right here in my arms. Hey, baby, they might call me crazy. From sigh and cry until there is no more. Forget how we felt so bad and shut up. It's time to get over. Blinded, I can't see the end. No matter how I start, have to play my part all the way through. It finally begins.
Really looking forward to Iris's cooking.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
Aw, don't be that way. It's different when a girl cooks for you. It's nice to not have to kill anything.
Prince Noctis, even the Marshal came to say goodbye.
I guess it's goodbye for now. The Regalia is already waiting below deck. Hopefully, she'll serve you as well across the ocean as she did here. Just don't break her, or Cid'll have your head. Hopefully, she'll serve you as well across the ocean as she did here.
Something I gotta get off my chest.
What's that?
I'm sorry. Sorry I wasn't there for your father. I swore an oath to protect the king, but I wasn't strong enough to uphold it.
Ain't nothing nobody could have done to stop what happened.
Yeah. I realize that.
But you need to realize just what you mean to the boys by your side.
Do.
Even if they can't solve your problems, you can't hide. hurts like hell. Remember, those ain't your bodyguards. They're your brothers. Trust in them, always.
You can never have too many tools. Here, learn to wield not only weapons, but magic as well. Just remember, it's a destructive force that doesn't discriminate. I suggest putting someone in charge of it.
Waiting for an invitation? Get your asses on board!
Hey! Your Majesty!
What's up?
Please! Come back soon! We need our king!
Yeah! Count on it!
The wedding day arrives, but alas, without the bride. Of course, we've come for the Hydrian, and you've gone to such lengths to prepare.
Merely my duty.
Ah, but for an outsider to lead the Imperial army must be a battle in and of itself. You've spoken to Lady Luna Freya.
No.
That obstinate secretary, standing in the way, while you rush off to slay the Hydrian for your poor sister's sake. I know the price of the Covenant.
You know, I've always wanted to go sailing like this.
Not many opportunities living in Insomnia.
Out here, it's just us and the horizon. It's amazing. It's life-changing. When we step off the boat, we'll be in a foreign country.
The anticipation alone is a foreign sensation.
Then to think this is where we were headed to begin with.
They've been through a lot.
And there's still more to come.
So next on the docket is Leviathan.
What sort of deity are we dealing with?
A serpent said to embody the roar and rage of the sea.
We'll have to see for ourselves.
Can't let Lady Luna Freya do all the heavy lifting. You must be so psyched to see her.
Luna?
Yeah.
Well, we need to make sure she's all right before anything else.
Indeed. Her well-being is top priority.
Don't like this going down on Imperial turf.
You think Lady Luna Freya's in danger there?
The Empire did invade Lucis for the ring. I have no faith their ruthless ambitions will stop short of harming the Oracle.
Without the ring, the crystal's no more than a rock.
I suppose. Does anyone know how Lady Luna Freya came to have the ring?
It seems likely His Majesty entrusted it to her safekeeping back at the Crown City.
So she's held onto it this whole time, all the way to Alticia.
The ring is important, and so is Leviathan. But Luna comes first.
You know, I was thinking back to our encounter with Ravus. Do you recall an apparatus in place of his arm?
Yeah, I remember.
Seems he lost his old one in the invasion. But in its place, he seems to have acquired new power.
Power?
That would help explain how a son of Tenebrae suddenly came to command Niflheim's army.
Now that you mention it, his strength didn't seem sort of supernatural. I just chalked it up to the Oracle lineage.
His ancestry may be part of it, but that alone wouldn't account for his freakish strength.
I wonder what could have happened to him.
There's a disturbing rumor about. Lord Ravus has taken to brandishing His Majesty's sword.
My dad's.
Then what's the big idea behind that?
That his power's the same as the power of kings?
I cannot say for sure, but I have my doubts. Ravus wears the sword, yet doesn't wield it.
For all his newfound powers, he's still the Chancellor's lapdog, holding on to the enemy king's sword like some badge of honor.
It might help if we knew what he was after.
Who can say?
What are the odds the Empire will crash the pool party with Leviathan?
Consider it a guarantee. They felled a god to prevent Noct from receiving his blessing. They'll do so again.
But we beat him to the big guy, thanks to our friendly guide.
Never know which way that one's gonna move next.
The Chancellor has an agenda all his own.
Sometimes it helps, like when he called off his army and let us escape.
But he was still a creep about it.
Well, it feels like he's only helping us because he wants something. I just don't know what.
Reckon we'll see him again?
Certainly hope not.
Not your type?
No love lost for phonies.
As Gladio said, his actions are motivated not by altruism, but by self-interest. And when he does come to our aid, I see only condescension in his eyes.
Yeah, can't argue with that.
Ever think you think too much?
Sometimes, but it's always preferable to the alternative.
So, soon you'll have your old man's ring back.
Yeah, when we arrive in Alticia.
Good thing. To him, it was his heritage.
Is that what my dad said?
Carrying a royal line ain't a task to be taken lightly. For a small thing, that ring can sure weigh heavy. After he became king, I only ever saw his face in the paper.
Wait, weren't you at the coronation?
No, I was long gone from the city.
Must have been invited, at least.
Had a falling out of sorts with your old man. Right at the end of the trip.
You did?
I was given to understand you stayed in touch.
We buried the hatchet years later, but never talked face to face again. Should have paid a visit while I had the chance. Well, no use dwelling on it now. Got the regalia in the hold, but you're all gonna stay in Alticia for a good while, right?
Yes, we believe so.
In that case, I'll tune her up for y'all. Not that I'll have much to do, though. Well, with Cindy looking after the old girl.
If you say she's good, she must be great.
She was never afraid of hard work. Heaven knows she had a hard childhood.
Hard childhood?
He means her parents.
Lost them both when she was little. was big enough to understand, though, and to hurt. But you wouldn't guess that, seeing her now.
Not at all. She's always so cheerful.
Well, that ought to tell you how far she's come.
Now, you must have seen your fair share of Alticia by now.
Yeah, only done been the once. Stayed a good while, though.
What's it like?
Big old city.
Big, okay.
Well, it ain't the Crown City.
Different. Got it.
You'll see for yourself. Foreign lands seldom lend themselves to trite explanations.
Change of scenery ought to do you good.
Well, I'm all talked out. Can't be far to Alticia now, right?
We'll be there in no time. Nice having the wind at our backs.
Lodgings are a first order of business.
All work and no play? Makes Ignis a dull boy.
Someone has to babysit you too.
Well, you're welcome to sleep in the wild.
Ain't no hotel, but I know a fella has a place.
Hey now.
Wescombe ran with Reggie and me way back when.
Oh, was he the other one in that photo with the garage?
Yep. Runs himself a diner or a cafe or something. Go and see for yourselves.
Sure.
Does the place have a name?
McGee or Magoo or Mago. That's the one.
Nice.
You can count on old Wes. He'll chew your ears off.
The government issued a statement promising that the reasons behind awakening the Hydrian would be clarified in the ceremonial address.
Got a signal!
Delivering the address will be Lady Luna Freya, who was previously reported dead. This will mark her first public appearance since the violence that spelled the signing ceremony.
Lady Luna Freya's gonna give a speech?
Sounds like it.
Lord knows. This world could use some wisdom.
Won't be much longer now, Noct.
Yeah.
Does this vessel have an entry permit?
Entry permit?
Relax. I got one. Here.
That's as old as they get. Seems in order. You may pass.
Prepared in advance.
Could say that. 30-odd years ago.
That's what the guy meant by old.
Lucky us, huh?
That could have ended badly.
What's next? Immigration?
What do you mean? There's still more?
Sir, what is the purpose of your visit?
Purpose, It's all yours.
Hey, didn't we just... we're here to visit a joint. Maga is the name, yeah.
Never heard of it.
Unless you're referring to the alternate entry program. In which case, you may pay the levy directly to me. This amount should suffice.
Oh, what a racket. This is your trip. You cough up the cash.
You want to check Wescombe's place out?
Yeah, let's all go to Mago.
Perhaps we'll even make it in time for tea.
And we'd better start looking now.
It's a photographer's dream.
What a city.
We should be pretty close to a famous photo spot.
Let's check it out.
Yeah, let's go! Ignis's cooking really is a class above.
You reckon?
What, you don't think so?
Seems pretty normal to me.
To royalty, maybe. To us plebes, it's anything but.
Rather sultry.
Yeah.
Gondola!
Care for a ride? Fantastic. Call when you need a ride back.
Welcome to Accordo, lads. Sid mentioned you'd be dropping in. Wescombe Armagh, that.
Take a shot from here.
Good call. Now it's picture time. Seems like the kind of guy who knows how to cook.
He does run a cafe.
Wouldn't mind sampling some of his handiwork. Let me get this shot.
Love the lighting.
Let's take a look inside.
So this is your maiden visit. Enjoying it so far? You doubtless have many questions, so ask away.
This country is a part of the Empire, isn't it?
Oh, you're wary. I understand. But there's no need to jump at every shadow. Just be aware that the terms of our independence grant the Empire free rein to come and go as they please.
We'll bear that in mind.
It's admittedly a one-sided arrangement. Most everything we do requires Niflheim's permission. And they wouldn't knowingly permit the Oracle to appear before the public. How our government spun that is quite a mystery.
So you see lots of Nifs around here?
We do, sometimes even at my place. Theirs is a familiar presence, and the citizens don't think much of it. Though the High Commander did cause a stir when he showed up the other day.
Ravus.
So soon after they fell the Archean and Lucis, his arrival fuels rumors that they will next come to Altisha. The Empire's not content ruling all the land. They want the heavens as well.
You really think Luna will make an address?
If every recent radio broadcast is to be trusted, absolutely.
Where is Lady Luna Freya?
In the city somewhere. But no one has caught so much as a glimpse of her. The media has been conspicuous in its silence on the matter, which speaks volumes of government intervention. That certainly explained the rumors of disgruntled Imperial officers leaving the city.
Has anything changed with Leviathan?
For now, it's business as usual at port. But word is the government will soon open the altar of the Tide Mother.
In preparation for the rite.
Ah, but on the other hand, they're scrambling to stockpile emergency provisions. This begs the question. If they're anticipating that the Hydrian will wreak havoc, why would they allow the rite to proceed? Well, if you need anything else, you know where to find me.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
My dear Camellia, it's been a while.
I heard about your distinguished guests.
Ah, you've an ear for gossip.
Gentlemen, I won't waste your time. My name is Camellia Klostra.
First Secretary of the Accordo Protectorate.
You should know, we have Lady Luna Freya in our care. And the Empire demands we surrender her.
What?
Yet I am loath to acquiesce unless we stand to profit. Hence I've come to discuss terms with the King of Lucis. If you've a mind to talk, come to my estate.
She can be oblique at the best of times, but I assure you, her heart is in the right place.
Oh, okay.
At any rate, you must be weary from your journey. Might I suggest you seek your beds for now and ponder matters anew in the morning?
Yeah, I think we'll do just that.
He just stood there, staring at the church and looking all sad. Can you blame him?
Remember, your heart is yours to follow. Just see to it that you proceed with caution. Should you ever need it, Margot is at your disposal.
Now I see why people flock from far and wide to the Walls of Water.
Let's grab a bite.
I was wondering when you might show up. So, what brings you here today? Looking willing to put your skills to the test, eh? You've outgrown your finicky eating, I trust. You're always welcome here.
Shop till you drop.
Million gill question. What are we eating?
He just stood there, staring at the tree.
Hey there. Have a good look. Lovely. See you later.
Welcome. You won't find fresher fish anywhere else. Pleasure. Come again.
See that fish? I wonder where you can catch it.
Dunno. Why don't you ask the shop?
Couldn't be bothered.
Oh, I know what you mean. I'm awkward around people, too.
Yeah, right.
Gentlemen, it has been a pleasure.
Is it evening already?
Time flies when you're having fun.
I'm so glad that Lady Luna's safe.
It's nice to not have to kill anything.
Do you see that, Noct?
What is it?
Are we staying here? Just so you know, I'm cool with camping.
Thank you.
How are you today? Till next time.
Gentiana.
Ahead lies a future uncertain, yet sure is the astral memory wherein the king may walk.
Greetings.
It's bedtime.
Huh.
Nice shot, Prompto.
Maybe I can make a living out of this.